Once you've initialized your array, chances are you're going to want to add or remove items. To add an item to the end of an array, I can use the append method, like this. Or, to add an item to a specific place in an array, I can use the method insertAtIndex. To remove an item, you use the method removeAtIndex. So, for example, to take out Flowrida, we need to specify that he's at index 3. But I don't think this playlist has enough country music, so we'll insert Keith Urban, and we'll put him at index 3. And then if we look over here in our sidebar, we can see that Keith Urban has been added to the array. If I want to know how many items are in my array, I can use the count method. If I want to retrieve an item, I can do so using subscript syntax. I just write the name of the array, and at the end, add the item's index as a subscript between square brackets. And here in the sidebar, we can see that the value DejLoaf has been assigned to the constant musician. We've written exercises to give you plenty of practice working with arrays. I think you'll find the syntax to be fairly intuitive. For now, let's continue on to dictionaries in the next section.